Here we have the KastKing Zephyr bait finesse reel. I have the spool set to just a hint of play. If I bring this up two clicks, there's no play at all. Slightest hint of play in the spool. And the magnetic brakes I have set to zero. These are the factory KastKing spool bearings. High speed bearings from speedspool.com. These are hybrid ceramics. These are the best ones that they sell. They're called the XCR. These, of course, are for my KastKing Zephyr. It comes with the two spool bearings that you need, the 3x10x4 and the 5x10x4. So we're going to go ahead and put these in and see the difference. I had to come out in the shed to get more light. It's still kind of hard to see, but I marked this factory spool bearing with a magic marker to get a little black line. I figured when I spun it, you would see it spinning, but you can't see too well. However, I'm only getting 3 or 4 rotations on this. That's it. Probably three rotations. Terrible. And then the speed spool. Check this out. You don't even need to see it. You can hear it. It's amazing. How many rotations is that? Still going. Yeah, I'd say this is going to make a difference. Unbelievable. These again are the XCR, the best bearings that they make. Size 3x10x4 and size 5x10x4 for the Zephyr, KastKing Zephyr. Let's do the original again. It's just stopped, 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 stopped. So what I was reading about that Zephyr is the reel in itself is fantastic, but the bearings obviously hold it back. So I paid $30 for these bearings from speedspool.com. $6.95 shipping, so $37 for two little bearings. That's half the price I paid for the entire reel. However, it just transforms it, and we're going to see that when I install these guys. So here I have the speed spool bearings installed, and we're going to run the numbers here. The OEM bearings, original equipment manufacturer, the KastKing bearings, doing the bearing test, the bearing would only spin for 1 second, actually less than a second. I was getting 0.8, 0.9, but we're going to round it up and call it 1 second. The speed spool bearing would spin for an average of 20 seconds. Now that's 20 times longer, or 2,000% longer. Okay, now on the spool, out of the box, the OEM bearings, I could get the spool to spin for 3.8, 3.9 seconds, so let's call it 4 seconds. With the speed spool bearings, this spool is spinning for 14 seconds. I'm getting 13, 14, 15 seconds. So we'll average it as 14 seconds. Now keep in mind, settings are all the same. The spool tension and the magnetic brake set to zero. So you're talking about 14 seconds. 14 seconds to 4 seconds. That's 2.5 times the spool rotation, or 250% longer. Now that's potentially a cast that's 2.5 times as far, or 250% further. And what's even more important, which I didn't show at the beginning, but the original out-of-the-box spool, if I was to move it like this, the spool would barely move. It would move maybe a quarter inch. The spool would move out of the box as far as my finger would move. That's how far it would go. Here you barely touch it and you see it spin like crazy, just barely touching it. And that is what's going to give you that ability to cast those really light lures or baits. It's going to get that spool to start up really quickly, where the OEM bearings, it just wouldn't move. And it's a shame that KastKing made such a great reel, yet kind of crapped out on the bearings. You know, I'm not going to say they're cheap bearings, but they just don't compare to these. You figure if I paid $30, average consumer, $30 for a set of these high quality bearings, a company like KastKing could buy them for $15. Even if they did not make a profit on the bearings, to put them in this reel, if you were to sell the reel for $15 more, for $90 instead of $75, you just transform the reel. And you wouldn't be losing any money, because you're just going to pass on that $15 to the customer. And it's really a shame, because obviously this reel is just superior just by adding these bearings. And one thing to keep note, I was reading about these ceramic bearings, ceramic hybrids or the full ceramic bearings, not to oil them, because the oil slows them down, because the ceramic bearings are so light and so precision that even an ultra light viscosity oil like the Bantam oil that I put on these bearings slowed it down. So what I did was, after I did the spin test, I put a tiny, like a half a drop of Shimano Bantam oil on this bearing. Did the spin test, it spun for like a second and a half. It was like the original OEM bearing. Instead of spinning for 20 seconds, it spun for like a second and a half. That tiny half drop of oil bog that bearing down. So what I did was I put the bearing in a little plastic container, put some paint thinner in it, shook it up for about 30 seconds, and then blew it dry and did the spin test again, and I was back to 20 seconds. So do not put any oil on these ceramic bearings or ceramic hybrid bearings. They're meant to run dry. But yeah, amazing difference with this reel. I can't wait to get out there and try it. And I'm going to do a little video first time I take it out.